ready to go. Stepping up for the Guardians, Stephen Kwan. And Pablo Lopez will deliver. In for a strike. Going to count one and two.
Well, at that velocity, if that's all you're seeing, 88, you can handle that all day long. That's what you get in batting practice. But off the velocity of the fastball, that is a very tough pitch to adjust to.
Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock. So a man on base to start the inning.
He was all over that one. Just kept it simple. Played pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from. And there's just no one there to knock it down.
And now, Miles Straw. Throw to second. Great jump. And that is a stolen base. It wasn't even close. The count 2-1. And a foul ball.
Now, the best way to shake off yesterday's struggles is to get on the board early. They've got a guy in scoring position. They've got to find a way here to get him in.
Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. Swing and a miss. Got him to go up the ladder for the K. And now it's Josh Naylor. And it's second. And there's a foul ball. That one is absolutely belted. And it hits the base of the wall. And they'll score first. It's Munson. Fires the second too late. And he's got a double.
Always feels good when you come through and get your team on the board first. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great.
And that one is lifted in the air. Kepler makes the grab. Two down. David Fry digs in for the Guardians. Runner at second, two down. And we're just getting started here in the top of the first. Popped up. Under this one. Makes the catch, inning over. Back in Target Field. And now for the Twins, Edward Julien. And the pitch. Ground ball right side. And it finds its way through for a hit. And aboard on the leadoff single.
He kind of rolled over on this pitch a little bit, but he got enough behind it to shoot it through for a knock. And we'll take that anytime you can get him to find a hole. And now a chance to maybe get creative on offense with good speed on first.
Here's Alex Kirilloff. Righty to the plate. Battling here as he fouls it away. Swings and he pops it up near the pitcher's mound. Settles under this one. To second for one. Here's Royce Lewis. Tying run is at first here in game one of this three-game set. And there's a ball.
2-1.
That's out number two. Here's Byron Buxton. Here comes a pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Two outs. Swings and misses on the fastball up in the zone for the strikeout. All set for the start of the inning. Bo Naylor at the plate now. 1-1.
Two ball, one strike.
Popped up. Lewis under it. Calls it in, and there's one away. Here's Brian Rocchio.
Man, he just couldn't lay off right there. Those high fastballs, they just look really good because they're eye level, but they're just about impossible to get the barrel to.
One out, base is empty. That one misses. 2-2.
He doubled up on the off speed there. We talk about the power fastball, but he's working a little differently here.
High fly ball, shallow right field. Kepler on his way in. Squeezes it. And there's two away. Two outs, base is empty. Here's Andrés Giménez.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
That's towards center. Correa on the move. Pulls it in on the run. And we're back. Bottom of the second. Ryan Jeffers at the plate. Flips the outside corner. Two balls, two strikes. Gets a piece and stays alive. The pitch. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. Now a screamer into the outfield. Straw racing over to make the catch. And here comes Carlos Correa. The Twins down by a run. Bottom half of inning number two. To the right side. Steps on first for the out. Max Kepler at the plate. Comebacker to the mound. Sends it to first, and it's a. And welcome back to the ballpark. New inning getting started. It's a win now for Cleveland, number 70. On the curve for a strike. Smoked on the ground a second. Over to first. He's out. One up, one down. Here's the Cleveland leadoff hitter, Stephen Kwan. One down, base is empty. Hammers that one. Curling down the line and foul. A line to kick the pitch. That one missing inside.
Two balls, two strikes.
Ground ball to the right side, and it goes just foul. That's hard hit on the line. Buxton pulls it down, and there's two gone. Two outs, base is empty. Now at the plate, Miles Straw. And the right-hander deals. That one ripped. Kepler brings it in. Back in Minnesota, and now the DH, Matt Wallner. That's a little bit low.
Three balls, one strike.
Swing and a pop-up. Drifts towards it. And there's one down. Here's Trevor Larnach. Left-hand hitter waits. And a swing and a miss. Home team down a run. You're in the last half of the third. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. He wasn't able to elevate it, but he put a great swing on it. Right on time, good balanced approach, and just blasted it through the infield.
Now it's going to be Edouard Julien. Deep drive down the line. Foul ball. Kicks and fires. And down on strikes. That's the second out. Now first base. Alex Kirilloff, the next Twin up to hit. Two outs. And a foul ball. Here's a 1-2. Stays alive. Swing and a miss. Back at Target Field. On to the fourth. And here's the first baseman, Josh Naylor. And a pitch. And a base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Couple of hits in a row for him here. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly. You know, these Guardians did a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way, and I'm seeing very patient at-bats out of him. He's only given up one run, but the starter's pitch count is starting to get up there, and that might be the best news yet for this offense.
Kepler hustles it back in. Rudder stops at second, and the first two reach to start the inning. David Fry digs in for the Guardians. Bunting, and he pops it up. Lopez over to second.
You know, sometimes all it takes is getting to the next arm before an offense does any damage, and that might be the case today.
Two on, one out. And next is the Guardians catcher, Bo Naylor. Cleveland up around looking for more. Double play ball to second. There's one. And that's two. Fourth, leading now the third baseman, Royce Lewis.
Third baseman.
And he deals.
Well, these Twins just lacking discipline at the plate in this ballgame. So many of their outs have come from weak contact on pitches they're chasing outside of the strike zone. You can't do much of anything with those locations, and that's been true again today.
That one missed.
And as a pitcher, when the hitters are swinging at everything, you feel no need to challenge inside the zone. You just keep working the corners and expanding that strike zone and beyond, and you just keep eating right out of your hand.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Byron Buxton. Close, but called a ball. 2-1. Good eye in that spot.
A rare three-ball count here. He's been throwing strikes all day. Got to be ready to hit if you're in the box.
3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
It's tough after falling behind a hitter, two balls and no strikes, but now at least he gets a fresh start against a new batter. But he needs to get back into the strike zone and start pitching with conviction.
Buxton back in there. Buxton leads off first with one away. Buxton on the run. Lost deep right field. Way back. And here. A gigantic blast. And they lead it. It's 2-1.
When you see a guy take a slider on the outside part of the plate and hit an opposite field home run, fires you up because not only is he flexing the muscles to show the pop, that kind of approach, you'll hit for a high average as well.
Here's Carlos Correa. One down, base is empty. The shortstop takes a ball.
Two balls, one strike.
Right through there for a strike.
Oh, and you can throw that big curve on the inside part of the plate. Very difficult pitch for the hitter to get on plane with. You can have a lot of success if you can pitch in that location.
Swing and a miss, struck him out. Now batting Max Kepler. And down on strikes he goes. Picks up strikeout number 7. Ready now for the 5th inning. Stepping up for the Guardians, Ryan Rocchio. And here it comes. In the air to left center, sizing this one up, makes the grab, one down. Now it's the second baseman, Andres Jimenez. The 1-1 is fouled off. Base is empty, one away, and we're at the top of the 5th. That misses the zone. 2-2. It's a good take. One down, base is empty. This ball's chopped on the ground. Kirilov throws the first in time. Here's the third baseman.
The third baseman.
1-1. Right through there for a strike. The Guardians trailing by a run here in game one of this three-game set. Can't connect on the curveball, struck him out. And welcome back to the ballpark. Now it's the DH, Matt Walmer. The pitch. That one finds the zone, and it's 1-2. And a curve is down and in. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. Trevor Larnin will hit next. The 1-1. And that one clips the corner. That's off the mark. The count now 2-2.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Trying to stay back a little bit longer for that changeup as he fouls that fastball back.
Ground ball nailer. Takes it himself. All man for the fifth inning, moving along two quick outs. Back to the leadoff spot in the Twins lineup. Edouard Julien now at the plate. So Cleveland brings on a new reliever, Sam Hentges.
And they felt it was time to bring on a left-handed reliever from the pen with the lefty hitter coming up. I think it's a good move. I know I never liked when opposing teams did that to me.
1-2.
Two down, nobody on. Got it. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. So in now for Cleveland, Stephen Kwan. The 2-1. Lined in the left center, should be extra bases. Into second base, the tying run is on with a leadoff double.
Well, that'll make you feel good as a hitter right there.
Showed a willingness to drive that pitch the opposite way. Didn't get jumpy, didn't try to pull the ball. He let it get deep, took the barrel right to it, and then extended through the swing for a line drive base hit.
Oh, now this ball's going to get through, and that's a base hit. The throw is offline, and he's in to score. It's 2-2.
Picks himself up an RBI. I don't know how he's able to shoot that pitch the other way and still put something on it. That pitch was inside, and he let it get really deep. So,
runner on the go. Pitch misses. Throw is low, and he can't pick it. And that's a stolen base, not even close. Man at second. Runner goes again. Swings, and he breaks his bat. Drops into the glove.
Yeah, that was a wasted RBI opportunity, but competitor like him, he is looking forward to making up for it in his next at bat.
Here's the pitch. Runner on the move. Strike in there. Throw to third. Save. On a line. Season, it's 4-2.
That one was a hanger, and pitchers typically don't get away with making a mistake like that. And right there, he made him pay.
New pitcher on here, Justin Topa. He has a great slider with tons of movement. David Fry digs in now. Right-handed reliever. So, a foul ball makes it 1-2. The pitch. Swings and misses, struck him out. Two outs, base is empty. Here's the catcher.
The bat.
Bone nailer.
The catcher.
Two outs, base is empty.
Nailer.
Oh, he throws it to his knee, the throw, and very nicely done for the out. And we're back. Bottom of the sixth inning. Now here is Alex Kirilloff. Swing and a miss. And the count is one and two.
The pitch started in and ended up on the outside edge, just changing planes and very difficult, especially for a left-handed hitter to track.
One, two now. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. The wind of the pitch. Close one, doesn't get the call. And the count is even, two and two. Swing and a miss, struck him out. Couldn't catch up to the heater. So digging in, Royce Lewis. Base is empty, one away here in the bottom of the sixth. And now two and two.
Man, that was pretty gross right there.
And there's a ball.
Looking to get something going. This is the guy you want at the plate. He's been great for this team. He is a professional hitter.
Side, and that is ball four.
Oh, a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to lay off some really close pitches, and somehow Boogie found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
The 2-1. Runner takes off. Swing and a miss. Safe at second, and that was not close.
You got to be careful with a guy like this at the plate. Stealing second may eliminate him from getting really good pitches to hit. Now they can work around him with first base open. So got to roll the dice here and hope that he gets something to hit.
And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. Two out. And now the Twins catcher, Ryan Jeffers. This is what stat nerds like myself might call a high leverage situation.
Yeah, but not sure what the numbers say, but clearly an at bat that could change the course of this game dramatically.
Next offering in there for a strike. And the count's full. Man on second, two down. Ripped to third. What a play, inning over. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Steven Ogre.
Pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches at home right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
Stepping up for the Guardians, Ryan Rocchio.
Both sides equally as strong, so not a good time to try to turn him around with a relief pitcher and put him on the other side of the plate.
The 1-2.
Ball.
Line drive.
Nice swing and good solid contact. That ball was smoked, but needed a little more width to get into the outfield gap. Maybe a little more backspin.
next offering in there for a strike. Now 1-2.
Clearly was sitting on a fastball right there. It just ended up out in front of the slider. Hey, you can't fault him for his commitment. Now he's just going to have to battle with two strikes.
Whips it to Kinlaw. And two away to start the seventh.
Now
the third baseman.
Fastball grew right down the middle. Usually a lot of damage done with that pitch. A hard grounder, but he wanted to get that ball in the air, maybe drive it into the gap.
Liner, base hit. So a two-out knock keeps the inning alive. Now Stephen Kwan, the next to hit.
Stephen Kwan.
And now the lefty. And there's a rocket into the outfield. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out.
Couple of singles back to back. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the ball straight to it.
Swing and a ball hit out towards left center field. And that'll fall for a base hit. To third, not in time. He's safe as a run scores.
Stringing them together, that's three hits in a row.
New arm out of the bullpen, Josh Stamos.
And this could be a pretty critical point in this game. They're hoping he's the guy to keep them within striking distance.
So two outs with runners on the corners. And up next for Cleveland, Josh Naylor.
With a runner at third, this is who they want at the plate. He's so good at getting a run across in these situations.
And a ball and two strikes. Hot shot to first base, and he snags it to end the inning. Back in Minnesota, now Gray up to hit. The Twins in striking distance, but have some work to do.
It starts with the leadoff man. Need a good at bat out of him right here. Now,
Nick Sandlin on a pitch here. This is his third time out this year. Kicks and deals.
2-1.
Well, these Twins, as this game goes on, have to be more disciplined at the plate. They've been chasing pitches outside the zone all game, and it's led to some frustrating moments. They've been fooled quite a bit today.
That's the third, and that chance handled. In plenty of time to first, and the leadoff hitter sat down to open the seventh. Max Kepler, the next Twin up to hit. The Twins trailing by three near the bottom of the seventh. On the ground right side. He takes it on his own. And that quickly, two away. So up next for Minnesota, Matt Wallner. Here's a 1-1.
Ball.
Swing and a miss, and that's strike two.
2-2.
Swings through it, and that's a strikeout. They turn things over to the southpaw, Caleb Fieldball.
And he comes on here for the first time this season, and I'm sure there's some nerves involved in that, so we'll see how he settles in.
Now it's Jose Ramirez.
With this kind of lead, he can swing freely, try to hit the ball out of the park, do what he loves to do.
The 1-1 out to short, zips it to first. David Fry digs in for the Guardians.
We talk about how the ball is coming out of the pitcher's hand, the way it comes out of his hand as an infielder,
Wow, really impressive.
Ball. And another ball. Base is empty, one away, and we're in the top of the eighth. And he swings and lifts one to deep center field. And that one hops the wall. Into second with a double, and they've got something brewing now.
Everything came together for him. Loud contact leads to the double. I mean, you could tell it had extra bases written all over it as it jumped off of the stick.
And here is Bone Naylor. That misses the zone. Ball two. One out, a runner at second. Here in game one of this three-game set. There's a swing and a drive. That one's back. Goodbye, home run. And they tack on to their lead. It's 7-2.
Pitcher tried to intimidate with that fastball up and in, but he was ready for it. Pulled the trigger, and man, explosive through the zone right there.
New pitcher on now, Griffin Jacks. He's into the game with the bases empty. One down. So in now for Cleveland, Brian Rocchio. One down, base is empty. Out towards right center field, Kepler under it. Pulls it down and he makes the catch. And there's two down. Stepping up for the Guardians, Andrés Giménez. The pitch. Rips that one to right. Stretches out and hauls it in. Bottom of the eighth. Now the left fielder, Trevor Larnach. Righty delivers. That one to first, Naylor. He'll do it himself. Out. One gone to the bottom of the eighth. Edouard Julien, the next twin up to hit. Out to short, Rocchio. Throws across the diamond. Two up, two down. Alex Kirilloff, the next twin up to hit. Two outs. On the ground to first. He handles it himself. Three up, three down, inning over. And welcome back to the ballpark. Here's the third baseman, number 70. Swing and a miss, 98 on the gun.
Sometimes a hitter will go up there and guess, and it's not just pulling something out of the sky, but expecting, because of tendencies, a certain pitch in a certain location. He just guessed wrong.
And up next for Cleveland, Stephen Kwan. One down, base is empty. That one misses, 2-1. Wouldn't chase that time. And a pitch. Line drive. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. That's out number two. Two outs. Base is empty. Miles Straw digs in for the Guardians.
I wouldn't say the game's close right now, but it's not out of reach either. I mean, these guys really need to put up a zero on the board just to maintain a little hope.
And a swing and a miss. And that's that. Target field, down the third baseman, Royce Lewis. The wind of the pitch. And a swing and a miss.
He has a tendency to chase out of the zone, and that slider that's down, that's one of his money pitches to get that swing and miss.
It's 7-3.
That's an impressive swing of the bat to go over the wall to the opposite field gap. There are a lot of guys that just don't have the pop to do that, and probably just as many who don't have the approach either. He let that ball travel, and he got great extension.
Now, here comes Emmanuel Clase out of the bullpen.
And he's got a nice lead to work with, so he should come in throwing strikes, attacking these hitters.
And the batter now, Byron Buxton.
One ball.
Nobody on, nobody out. We're in the last half of the ninth inning. And a good eye there.
Really nice slider right there. Sweeping across the dish, but just couldn't hang the edge.
Caught him looking for the K. And now here is Ryan Jeffers. The 2-2. Got him looking, and he didn't like the call. So they're down to their final out. And now the shortstop, Carlos Correa. The Twins down by four here in the last half of inning number nine. Misses just off the outside edge. I think that was a strike. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. This could end it. Comes a 2-2. And that just misses. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. And that is the ball game.
It's always nice to grab the opener of a series. You come into a new ballpark, and just sometimes things aren't as comfortable as what you've been used to. The mound doesn't look straight. The background isn't what you like, but they didn't let any of those things distract them. In fact, they looked like they were playing a home game. Excellent job to set the tone for this series.
7-3 is how this one ends. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciampi saying so long.